There's one person there. And there's people. How many people are at the bar? Should we just wander out? They're just gonna. We're just wandering out casually. Don't know. It's fine. Yeah. That was quieter and darker, it has to be said. Which makes me think some people have left. Imagine. Who's left, guys? Who's left? Right. Let's plug this in. Gonna just tweak. For some reason Periscope isn't working in Bath, so I'm having to it's too boring to even say what it is. I'm too boring. I'm just gonna stop talking about stuff. Just going to tweet. You say hello to the boys and girls.
All right. Are you recording?
Yes.
Do you do the thing?
No, not yet, because I've got to.
We were talking in the dressing room about how weird this whole Sue thing was, and I'm actually quite concerned about Sue. What the hell has happened with Sue? We were going to phone with my phone, weren't we?
Yeah, have you got your phone?
Hey, man, what's
your name?
It's Alan.
Hey, fella.
Greg.
Okay, Craig. Craig, snap, right, okay. 1-0 to me, you've got to be faster. What's your name?
Sabini.
Well, wouldn't, you don't know, miss. Have we got another, just say Sabini. What's your name?
Sabini.
Snap, 2-0. 2-0, you've got to be quicker than that, very quick. What's your name?
Celia.
I drove, this is Celia, ladies and gentlemen, and I brought Celia here because I'm going to propose to her. I'm not really. But I drove a sports car for you once. True story. Okay, what's your name?
Anne.
Hello, Anne. What's your name?
Andy.
Hang on, there's a hand up. Yes, sir, what would you like to say?
My name's Andy.
Ah! Oh, you got it! It's 2-1! Oh! We got name snap. Who needs cats? She's rubbish. Anyway, right. Anne and Andy was close, but Andy and Andy is closer. What's your name, sir?
Jonathan.
What's your name, sir?
Chris.
We've got Jonathan, we've got Chris. A lady Chris would work as well, guys. A lady Jonathan would work would be weird. Hang on a second, I'm just getting a vibe.
Lady Chris.
There's a problem. What you can't see is there's a bloke pointing to a woman going, Lady Chris. And Lady Chris, I'm going to say she's no lady, because she turned around and she went, fuck. Is your name Chris? Snap, 3-1 to me. You've got to be quicker than that, guys. You've got to be quicker than that. I'm getting a very strong vibe here. What's your name?
Amy.
How old are you, Amy?
16.
Oh, you're the 16th. Steady. Right, wait, apologies. I'm really sorry, but you've got terrible, terrible parents. Imagine them bringing you... I'm sorry, you have to deal with that. You have my sympathies. What was your name?
Amy.
I don't know, I was just checking, making sure. What's your name?
Claire.
What's your name?
Claire!
Disqualified, mate. She hadn't fucking said it. She hasn't said it, you're disqualified. 3-1 to me still. You got me? He was saying, I didn't even get your name.
Claire.
Snap, right, okay. Hold on, hang on a second, we've got a hand up here. This is so much more fun without Kath.
Claire.
Hang on a minute, sorry. Who are you snapping that with?
Myself.
I'm John as well with that guy.
Right, okay, John, you've just made a copy weird now, right? To be honest, I don't think you're taking the name game. How long does it take to get a fucking phone? She's doing fine. We don't need her. The show's. Oh, I didn't record any of that bollocks. Right. No. Okay. Oh, so what's your name? Okay. What's your name, though?
Alex.
Okay. What's your name, though?
Sabini.
It don't matter. We know it. We know it happened. I think we put too much emphasis on recording things these days. And I preferred it when we just remembered things. Controversial. Unless he actually does have it. Now you ruined it. This is a phoning show. It's the Kath hasn't bothered to turn up today because she's a slacker. And if anything, I think the show's going better without her. Now, people can phone in at any point and leave messages. And here's a message, and it's for you guys, okay? So you're going to have to keep the lights up, because you're going to have to do a little bit of work here, guys. Here we go.
Hello, Ian. Hello, Cass. Hello, Bass. How are you all doing? I just want to try a bit of audience participation, if that's okay. I'll need everyone to just stand up, and it's going to be a case of... I'll be picking people out of the audience from my home, and also I'm in the past at the moment, so this is going to be good. And I'm going to tell certain people to sit down, and whoever's left standing at the end of it, I'm going to reveal something about them, and we'll see if I'm correct. So we'll just start with everyone standing up, please. I'll just wait 10 seconds while everyone stands up.
They stood up, mate. They stood up. We did it a minute ago. Right,
here we go. So if anyone is wearing a black item of clothing, can they remain standing and the rest sit down, please?
Okay, that's so good.
Okay, and the next one is, anybody who owns a pet, can they remain standing and the rest of the people sit down, please?
You soulless pet haters, look at you. Okay, they sat down.
Okay. And we'll go for one final one. Yep. Anybody who's wearing glasses, can they remain standing and the rest of the people sit down, please?
Okay,
so the people that are currently remaining standing, I'm going to reveal something about them. Now, using my best psychic abilities, I can tell that the people that are remaining standing are all very nice people, and they have all offered, well, they don't know yet, but they will be offering to buy the rest of the place drinks for the rest of the night.
Hey, round of applause! Well done, guys! Well done, Sabini! Well done, John, Craig, Andy. Well, that was good. Right, here's the annoying thing, right? Kathy's just sat there like a dick, laughing, thinking, oh, this is funny, because Ian's having to do it all on his own. Well, I'm an old school entertainer, and I don't mind doing things on my own. And if Kath doesn't want to come out, then Kath doesn't have to come out, and I'll just carry on doing it Lee style-y. And Okay, fine. Then this is what we're, okay. Hang on a minute. If that's what she wants, then that's what she's gonna get. Okay. Stay with me a while. Stay and let me look at you. I've traveled halfway around the world, finding you at me. Though it's been a long time, and I'll drive you wild. I always gotta say what I've gotta say. September morn, we danced until the night became a brand new day. Two lovers playing scenes from some romantic play. September morning still can make me feel that way. Wish I'd chosen a song that I knew the words to, but the pressure was on. It was the first karaoke song I could find. Da-da-dum. have been such a dick. But the show's been better without her, don't you think?
Yes!
September on, we danced until the night became a brand new day. Fuck you.
I love you.
Yeah, I came up with the new, no.
What?
I came up with a new show that when I'm in Good Morning Britain tomorrow,
yeah.
I'm going to tell them about it. It's called Name Snap.
Oh!
Yeah, it's really a lot of fun. Apart from that guy that ruined it. So, have you got your phone?
Yes.
Have we got a German speaker?
Yeah.
Oh, he's gone. Right, come and join. Right, come and join. This is. We're going to find out the Sue thing, and then don't worry, the vibe is going to pick up again, and it's going to be. We're going to have a great vibe, guys. Trust me. Come down and join. It's Marcus, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Paul Marcus. Right. So you need to dial that number there, 00. He's Italian.
Oh.
Speaks three languages, as opposed to my seven. Okay, that's it. That's good. 0-0.
Three is good.
Is. You a very romantic man, Marcus?
No.
I am. I'm very romantic and I speak seven languages. Still not to boast about it. Very romantic.
Just double check that.
Yeah, that's about right. Right. So this is them. Okay, here we go. It didn't work. You did it. Oh, for fuck's sake. Yeah, it's there. She's missed out the entire section.
I said double check it. Did you double check it? Did you bollocks?
Right. Have you got enough credit on this?
Yes.
I'm with. It does. I'm with GIFGAF, so I wouldn't be able to do this.
Oh, I'm with GIFGAF.
Hashtag me too.
Hashtag me too! Right, here we go. Right. I have to hold it here for it to be easy.
No, it doesn't sound like Switzerland.
Doesn't matter, sometimes it...
Hello?
Ja, was ist denn?
Hi, grüß dich. Mir hat Mom von der Sue einen Anruf gekriegt und kannst du mir den... Weißt du, wer die Sue ist?
Bitte? Was
wenn
der
was?
Yesterday.
It was
Marcus! What did he say?
When was it?
No, alright, I'm kind of, for fuck's sake, we got that bit. What maybe there was other bits of the conversation we missed, Marcus.
No, there wasn't very much.
So it's weird because he didn't say there is no Sue.
Well, I don't let him, you don't know! Let's ask Marcus!
Did he say there was no Sue?
No, he didn't. He didn't say something like that. I just asked if he knows someone, and she just asked where or when the call was. Yeah.
That's it.
The dungeon.
It did sound like some of it was you said in English.
No, it was Swiss German, which is a very odd dialect.
Okay.
So, it's, yeah.
Mark, give a round of applause for Nicholas Hall. Thank you, Marcus. Thank you, brother. I appreciate that. That is very mysterious, man. Very, very mysterious. We're going to open the phone line. 0203-286-6370 is the phone number if you're watching us live on YouTube. And you can Skype Hey Rabbit Hole Show if you want to do that. Oh, I am reminded that who here listens to the talk radio show that we do together?
Yes.
Yes. Beautiful. Well, good. Well done. Well, there is a young lady who calls us. Where does Jazz? Hello. Yeah. Do you want to turn your speakers off? What the fuck is going on tonight? Hello, can you hear us?
Are you?
It's uploaded!
funniest thing I've ever seen. Brilliant. Yeah, you could just hear. Yeah.
You notice how quickly everyone grasped you up as well. Everyone grasped. You see something suspicious. You've got to tell. I forgot what. Oh, so. All right. Let's see who this person is, and then we'll. Hello, caller.
I was up in New York for the Anthony Cumia show. The guy named Ron Bennington was co-host. And I knew Bennington didn't know anything about who I was, what we write about, what I talked to Anthony about many times. So Bennington decides he's going to, you know, kind of like have a little fun at my expense. I thought, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to use him as an example of clueless people talking about things they don't know anything about.
Okay. We've got plenty of examples of that, I'm sure.
Loads.
Jasmine.
Yeah, she's Swiss.
She's from Switzerland. Jasmine is a caller to the show. And she was telling me that tonight, from 9 o'clock, so 10 minutes ago, she is going to, and I couldn't quite, it's not worked out why, she is going to, what's the phrase? I want to say spatially disoriented.
No, sensory...
deprive herself. Yeah. She wants to sensory deprive herself.
Yeah, she's going to wear an eye mask and earmuffs.
Yeah, all right. She's going to sense, but there's a phrase that I'm struggling to...
Sensory deprivation.
There we go. She's going to sensory deprivation herself.
Yeah.
But she's also, she's going to stream it on Periscope. If you've got a phone and you want to go on Periscope now, I'm going to click on it. We haven't got screeners. You can't. I'm going to click on it and see. It's periscope.tv/JAISA_96. JAISA_96. We're connected, but now I can't see. This may not work because I can't see any pictures. It says it's connected. Is it? Maybe she's sensory. She's in a dark room.
She's depriving us as well.
It says connected. It says live from Switzerland, 24-hour project. Well, maybe there's a problem with Periscope, because Periscope's been a big shit tonight. That might be it. Oh well, that was going to be the next 30 minutes. That leaves us a little bit buggered, Catherine.
Well, I might go.
Well, if it's not working, you won't be able to. That seems pretty obvious to me. How's that going there?
Loading.
Yeah, just
loading.
Okay, what's happening is that the vibe is being sucked out even more.
That's what she can see, guys.
Okay, thanks. Can I say it?
Yeah, go on.
Right, when I obviously know what I'm doing,
let me know.
Sort of going behind. You basically what you said there for the last. Yeah. Minute and 25 seconds was, yeah. You're a tit,
yeah.
And I don't trust you. I have my suspicions as to who that was. What I would like from you is...
A...
No, but seriously, what I would like from you is just a little bit more respect.
Anyway.
Okay. You shouldn't speak to me like that, and I'll tell you for why. I am, and this is absolutely true, right? I am now a teen idol. And this is not even a joke. This is true.
It sounds like one, but...
It isn't a joke. I now understand the pressures that drove David Cassidy to an early grave, because I'm experiencing similar pressures to him. I don't know if you know, guys, but last year I appeared on television show called Lunch Time to Get Me Out. I came third. Well, I should have come second, let's be honest. Should have come second. There was a gap of between second and third of 0.09% in the votes. So whichever three of you didn't fucking vote for me, you're the reason I came to them. That's fine. It was a lot of fun. And we had a really great time with those guys. Apart from the tossers, which was all of the fuckers. But since coming back, the weird thing that has happened is I am now recognisable to kids. Yeah. Kids know who I am. And we have a 16, we have a, the spokesperson for the youth here, a 16-year-old in the audience.
Yeah.
Who is here representing. She is representing her crew from the playgrounds to the happy shopper. She is representing, and there are Zeds in that representing. And I also think that Stormzy is very good. I'm speaking her language. I'm tempted to rip my shirt off and make a protest. Probably something a little bit closer to home, like, I don't really get that fussed about anything these days.
Well, apart from at that time someone drew a cock on your car.
That was out of order. That was out of order. It may actually have been a young person that did it, because I believe that is one of their hobbies. So actually, I'm not talking to you. No, I'm representing. What the fuck, you didn't think? What the fuck, Mrs. Theresa May? Fuck you! So it's grime, I'm doing grime.
Are you? Is that,
yeah. What the, rips his shirt off. What the fuck? What the fuck, Theresa May? Fuck you!
Why are you going on Pacino?
I was trying to do Pesci, actually, but... we got the user represented here. There was an S in there, because I'm spelling it properly now. Can't remember what we're talking about. Hello, caller!
Hello?
Hello there!
Hello.
Yeah, hello, who is this?
Zach.
Hello, Zach, what do you want? I'm busy. Oh, that's rude. It's another youth. You probably know him. He's a young man called Zach. You probably had a Snapchat with him at some point. Hey, Zach. Hey, man.
I've just been looking into this thing that happened in Nessa with the explosion. It looks pretty, pretty bad.
Okay. I mean, we say people. I know. Jesus. That's not good, is it?
No.
I think he's crying. Hello, caller. How would you like to buzzkill the show?
Hello.
Are you calling us from the venue?
Who's there?
No, he's not allowed to drive.
Hello?
Hello? Hello,
Ian?
Yes, Andre, hello.
Hi, how are you?
I've been better.
Yeah, well, same, yeah, but it's snowing here. That's the trouble, but it's even worse.
Yeah, then it does. It must be.
Yeah, oh. Sorry, let me get a word in, please, Ian.
Okay, so. Well, I think Stormzy should have his Brit Award taken away from him.
Why?
For being disrespectful to the Prime Minister of this country. Yes, he may have issues, but you don't. What you don't do, right, is you don't rip off your shirt, mm-hmm. have fake rain poured on you, and F this, F that, F Mrs. Prime Minister's Theresa May. You don't do that. What you do is you wait for a general election, you go in, and you vote. That's, thank you, isn't it? Isn't it? All this F you, Mrs. No, fuck you, Stormzy.
Wow.
Fuck you, Stormzy. Having a go at my Prime Minister. Fuck you, Stormzy. That's what I say. See how Stormzy likes that. The dads fight back. Fuck you, Stormzy, with your back. How dare he fucking swear in front of our children?
He's right in front of their child.
No, well, okay, no, I know. This is the 16-year-old has moved there. You would know that if you'd been here for the start of this show. But the reason I'm swearing in front of her child, the reason I'm swearing in front of that child is because her parents are bad. Because her parents are bad. And have brought it here. So that's her parents' fault and Stormzy's fault. So Stormzy's a bad influence is what I think. Hello, caller!
Yo, this is Stormzy. You're effing b-hole. Now listen, man. carry-on bags in Asda, they're 9p! I've never heard of that. F in this or F you in that.
Stormzy, you were very disrespectful to the Prime Minister. He's hung up. There we go.
Disrespect for you? Disrespect?
What's a beehole? A blowhole?
A butthole.
Oh, okay. Well, we won't have, we can bleep that out. We won't allow language like that. But I like listen, I like Brian.
You love the
Brian,
don't you?
There's a time and a place for it. I just love good music, you know what I mean? Hello, caller! I've got to do so much work these days. Yes, you're down the rabbit hole.
Are you there?
And what would you like to say?
Can you ask me the question or what?
Say that again, what?
Hello?
Hello, yes. What do you want?
What do I want? Right, so you know some questions that like keep you awake for hours at night? I need you to help me answer this question, right? I travel over 300 miles to go and see a friend. We're in his flat, he sat sitting in the thing and throws into it. Should I keep him as a friend or not?
No! What did you understand any of that?
Yeah, she said she travels 300 miles. Should you be a friend or not?
Are you in love with him?
What?
Hello?
No, definitely not.
Are you not even?
Definitely not.
There must be a little bit of attraction. Am I right?
No.
Are you in a fit state to drive home?
No, I don't think there's any state to drive home. We'll start properly in a minute. I just feel we're kind of warming up here at the moment. Mm. Let's have some cat facts.
All right. Guess what got discovered in a back garden in Bath?
A bomb.
Uranus.
Hey. Okay. Well, I know who discovered it.
Go on.
Sir William Herschel.
Correct.
I thought you guys would be more impressed by that, if I'm honest.
And why do you know that?
Because I went to the Sir William Herschel Grammar School in Slough.
That's a bit cruel, isn't it?
What?
Well, all those kids going to the school that's about the Uranus man.
No. We called it Uranus, Kath, because we were mature.
Everyone knows it's Uranus.
It's Uranus, and you're just being a dick. That joke is for, like, kids. Who are, you know, did he discover it? I thought he discovered it. Sorry, I'm not questioning it. Okay.
Telescope, back on.
Why do it be with a fucking telescope? He's not going to go, ah, me!
There it is.
What's that? What are you going to call it? You don't want to know.
Let me just
send this letter off. Guys, trust me, it's going to be a slow burn a bit. It's going to be a great gang. Okay, well, that's a great bit of cat facts.
That's an absolutely true cat fact.
Yeah.
Also true. The Greek word for soap is smegma.
It's not. What is the Greek word for soap then?
I don't know, but smegma is the gucky stuff you get between your toes.
The eight and
the. I think that was the joke. Right. Okay.
It's the ancient Greek word for soap.
Take that.
Deal with it.
Right.
It's a fact. I found it on
Google. There was a Greek speaker. Ah, Tikanis. Ah, Polycala. There we go, you see. You're obviously Greek.
Yes.
So why don't you...
Ancient Greek.
Don't be so rude. She's younger than me. I'm so sorry. Why don't you destroy her?
I'm not that old.
What's the
modern Greek for so?
Saponi.
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 Oh.
Here's my favourite Greek word.
Go on.
The Greeks do not have a word for toes.
It's my favourite.
They don't have word for toes. Mm. So what do they call them?
Foot fingers.
Fingers of the things. Fingers of the things.
Spanish is the same.
This is the home of democracy. It's my my mother-in-law is Greek, and she will come with everything. Oh, that's Greek. Oh, the Greeks. Oh, the Greeks did that better. I can't remember any Greek. I once tried to write I wrote a joke in Greek, but none of my Greek family would get it. They would always be annoyed with it. So joke for one person, and bear in mind, every other Greek person I've told it to has gone, what? I can't remember what it was. It was a pun on the word stomata.
What's stomata?
What's stomata? Okay, here it is. So stomata means to stop, right? So, what's the matter?
Stop.
I was only asking how you were doing.
Hey, that's excellent.
Yo, come on, man. I know only one song in Greek.
Oh, good. You haven't got it.
But it's a long one. Kephalion. Oh, what are the words? Kephalion. No. Oh, what's shoulders? Omo.
Do your scouse impression.
Shut the fuck door. Kephali omo ketaktila to bother you. Kephali omigonata ketaktila to bother you. What the fuck are eyes? Matya.
Aftya.
Sounds like a doctor. We'll edit this down and I'll sound good. Matya, aftya. Give me 10 minutes. Hang on. We'll do it later. It doesn't matter.
Excellent. We'll hold on.
It's a great language, Greece. It's a great country, Greece. One of the greatest countries in the world. Although, I think you would agree, there is a reason why they are, they've been in financial difficulties. It's because they're all bent. They're all bent over there. No, they all, oh, come on. No one asks for receipts. No one pays tax. My wife's aunt, everything is cash. I said to her once, why don't you get receipts? And she just laughed. And they don't, and the tax man will come round.
What's the thing with only building, like they build half a house and then leave it that way so they don't have to pay for the whole...
Isn't
that a thing?
Something like that, and they don't have to pay land tax or something, I don't know. But I love it. Oh, some souvlaki right now will go. I tell you, last time I was here, I went to, there was a burger place over the road. And this was like two or three years ago.
Yeah.
And me and Will went and had kangaroo burgers, right? And they were all right, but I had an upset stomach the next day. And then about 6 months later, Will sent me a little link saying that that place had been closed down because it was like the filthiest, shittiest shit burgers. And there's a new
place.
It wasn't called shit burgers. But apparently it was like, it scored like minus numbers on the rating system.
And we've been in some really dodgy places.
That place was worse.
Do you remember that place we got locked in? With all the dead flies in Loon. We couldn't leave. There was a shop next door.
Oh, and then a guy came in who pretended he was Portuguese.
Yeah. It was a very weird, anyway.
Hello, caller. What is wrong with these people tonight? Don't they realise we're the... Hello, Mario! Hello? What is wrong with this guy? Hello? He's there. I'm going to turn on my video so he can see me. Hang on a second. Hello? He's hung up. What the fuck was that? I'm not having that. He's gone offline now. I'm phoning the back. What's wrong with these people? Why would you do that? What kind of sick pervert phones up and doesn't...
And say maybe he's finished.
Oh, well... it's possible. You don't get the... is this true?
What?
My nephew told me this. He's 12. And he said, if you want to stop a sneeze, you have to say potatoes.
I've never tried it.
Is anybody feeling sneezing?
My daughter told me it was pineapple.
Ooh. He said it specifically, it's got to have an O's at the end of the word. But pineapple or potatoes? We just
try being placed on hold.
There we
go.
Here we go. Here we go. If anyone feels a sneeze coming on, interrupt whatever it is we are doing, because let's be honest, it won't be much. And come and grab a microphone and say
hello.
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 Did you manage to measure those fingers? He's gone. Okay, right. It's gonna be one of those things. We'll start in a bit. Hang on a second. Oh yeah. So I'm a teen idol. That's what I was talking about. Yeah. I knew there was something.
You're now known not as Ian Lee, but Ian.
Ian from the Jungle.
Ian from the Jungle.
And it was my kid's 8th birthday party today. It was his birthday a month ago, but we were late with the party. It was his 8th birthday. So we went ice. Oh, that was it. Fuck it. That was what we were going to talk about the whole night. I forgot about this. It was an ice skating special. I forgot. What is the point of ice skating? Right. Because I went ice skating today. And because my boy wanted to go for a birthday party, he'd never been ice skating before. I blame the Olympics for drilling this shit into his head. So we went ice skating, and I have no idea where the fun is meant to be in that. There's no fun in it, because you've got to put the boots on, and they were too tight, and they're digging into my feet. Then you've got to kind of tiptoe out to the ice, and then you just go around in a fucking circle.
Did you fall over?
I fell over twice.
Well, that's where the fun is.
No.
For everyone else.
I mean, that's...
Who picked you up?
Oh, right, this is true, right? So, I fell over. I did only fall over twice, and I couldn't get up, right? And so this girl came over to me. She was about 14 years old. And she went, are you all right, sir? Would you like a hand up? And I went, yeah. First of all, I thought about it. I thought, oh, fuck it. I've got no pride in it. Yes, I would, if you wouldn't mind. So I took one hand, and I took the other hand, and she started to pull me up. She went, and then she's holding me. She went, oh, my God! And I fell back on my arse.
She dropped me.
She went, oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, it's you. I voted for you. I went, yeah. Can you help me get up, please? And she was called Gemma. She was so sweet. She was really, really sweet. She got all flustered. And, she kept coming around. And I was with my youngest, who we couldn't skate. And she kept coming, and she was looking after my boy. She was so sweet. And at the end of it, she came and asked for a selfie and stuff. But then we went upstairs to have the party food, and there was another party going on in the corner. Mm-hmm. And it was a girl's 9th birthday party.
Better party, was it?
Oh, it was a much better party. They were having a great time. Still the same crappy cold food that they serve at these places. Horrendous. But then I was talking to my father-in-law, and then he sort of nudged me and went, I think someone wants to have a word with you. I looked down, and all of these, it was 15. 8, 9, 10-year-old girls were just stood there, looking up at me like that. And I sort of was looking down at them. And this is the thing, the kids don't initiate the conversation. So
they're used to watching you.
I went, hello, what are you all doing here? And they just went, is it you? And I said, yes. But then, this is what is great about kids, because there's only 3 of them knew who I was, and the rest just knew I was someone that had been on the telly, so they were excited by that. And then this girl went, what did you do to become a celebrity? And I went, I was on the telly years ago. She went, well, I'm 10 and I've never seen you on the telly. And I said, well, the thing I did was like 20 years ago. She went, God, you're old. God, you're so old. And then just walked off. And then...
That's a diss.
And then at the end, because I know how to play it now, I said, see what, if you go back to your party, before I go, I'll come and have a picture taken. Like, hell yeah. We went and had a selfie, and then I came back to the party. And then I left, right? So I left my party where it's just like, oh, Dad. This was the first day, right? Went to put my arm around my 8-year-old son, and he just went,
oh, like that.
And I thought, right, well, I'm gonna. So I went to the girls, and I went, bye, girls, I'm off. And they went, ah! And screamed at me.
So I prefer other people's children.
I can't imagine why your kids are so embarrassed.
Well, they deserve it, those guys, those crazy guys. It's that age, my eight-year-old just, oh no, don't, it wouldn't hurt me.
Oh.
Well, it's evolution, it's natural, it's what happens, and he won't, there'll be a point where he won't talk to me, there'll be a point where he gets drunk and punches me, there'll be...
He's about 10. Does he hold your hand across the street still, or is he getting embarrassed about that yet?
Oh, he's not held my hand across the street for ages.
Really?
Yeah. The youngest does, and I'm getting my money's worth out of him, because that's not going to last. That won't last forever, you know, so I'm getting hugs and things off of him, but he doesn't last.
I've noticed with my...
Well, the open chat's been serviced. The person you're calling is unable to take your call. Please leave your message after the tone.
Okay.
To re-record your message,
I've turned it off. I've cancelled the call. Hang on a second, what have I done then? I have cancelled the call. Okay, so that's that.
Bye.
What's that, Tom? What about your kids? They
She stopped leaving the door wide open when she goes to the toilet.
Good.
That's a little sign that she's moving on.
That's disgusting. You don't want to.
Maybe I should stop doing it as well.
I don't. That's one thing I don't get. Hello, caller. What is going on? Hello?
What do you do?
What? Hello? I don't know what's going on with this.
Hijinks.
Hijinks. Hello, caller, you're down the rabbit hole.
Hello? Baby now, baby, do what I should have been.
Yes?
Hello?
Hello, yes?
I'm fussing, yeah?
Go on then.
Alright, I'm fussing.
Take... What
the fuck is the... Yeah, alright,
hold on. Right, hang on a minute. We're going to call him from your phone.
You're bloody
not. I'm going to 141 it, don't worry. Type in your code, please.
Just use my thumbprint because it's the modern day.
Who does the thumbprint shit?
This guy.
Right, okay, are we in? Right.
No, come here.
I know you're not in.
What are you doing?
Type the code in. Jesus. Right, we're in. Right. 141. 07. There we go. Here we go. Here we go. This is it. This is it. Now we're talking.
Hello?
Yeah, do you want to sing your song now?
Sorry?
Do you want to sing your song now?
Yeah, really?
Yeah?
Okay, starting, actually.
There we go.
Can you hear the background or not?
Yeah.
Wait, I'm out anyway.
Yeah, don't mind.
Yeah. Right, people really know that anyway, yeah?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
John. Kid. A real, it's a bit of an extended mix, this one.
Oh, God.
It's dry. You'd be pleased to know. I want everyone dancing in the audience.
Nope.
So this, the pages, the girl in this book, says one. Just get some rewards. There's no 45s. They don't have to. Is it? Anyone dancing?
No.
Not yet. Keep going. They're warming up.
Come on. Right, they're warming up. The real. Maybe now, baby.
Maybe now, baby.
Maybe
now,
baby. Maybe now, baby.
Maybe now, baby.
Do what I should have done. Is that enough or keep going?
Yeah, that's fine. That's enough.
Wow.
That's enough. I mean, I really... plugging in. I really don't feel we've given the boys and girls their money's worth this evening. So, let's play... we've got a couple of... let's just try this. Hello, caller!
Hi, are you?
Yes, hello, caller.
How's the show going, mate? All right.
Is that John Lennon?
No, Jamie.
Jamie.
I phoned you a few weeks ago, but I had another event.
Okay, yeah, the show's, you know, the show's, I'd give it a 5 out of 30.
Yeah, of course. Oh. But you can get better, mate. Where's the strangest place you've ever woke up, mate?
Where's what?
Where's the strangest place you've ever woke up?
The shadiest place I've ever woke up. Well, what I used to do when I was a drinker, and when I was like a teenage drinker, because all my friends lived in Slough, and we moved like quite a few miles away to Farnham Common, keeping it real. And there were no buses late at night, and I couldn't afford a cab because I was like 16, 17, 18. So what I would do is I had two techniques to help the journey home. You have to walk home, it was a walk about 2 hours. Is I would get pissed, and I would sometimes run as far as I could, and then walk because I was out of breath, and then run. Absolutely wasted, because it would get me home quicker. But what I would often do is I would find like a front garden or a bus stop or like a little, you know, a grass verge, and I'd just have a little nap. Just like 15, 20 minutes to give me the energy to get home again. So a grass verge off the Farnham Road in Slough is probably at the age of 17. God, when you say it like that, it sounds horrific. Doesn't it?
I'm always worried that I'd be found in a ditch.
Yeah.
Didn't think that I'd be sleeping.
I fell asleep in Manchester and ended up in the Lake District.
How did you do that, man?
Alcohol, mate. Plenty of it.
Okay. But what? Did you fall asleep on a train or something?
Well, yeah, mate. And then I got arrested for having no pants on. I thought I was at home, mate. I've gone stripped off the bed and I'm in the room.
Yeah.
Wowzers.
It was a shock to me as well, mate.
Oh, I'm sure it was more of a shock to the other passengers. Well, thanks for sharing that, man. I hope you're well.
No worries, in a bit.
Take care, thank you. There we go. See you in a bit. Well, what does that mean? Hang on, whoa. See you in a bit? Is he outside?
No, no, pants on.
Oh, God. That's horrendous. I mean, I never woke up anywhere really shady. I'd never really, there was a little nap on the way home I would have. But even when I was drinking, it was never,
I've fallen asleep in pub toilets a couple of times.
Oh, yeah, I've done that. Yeah.
They're closing, they kick me out.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got carried out.
No.
Yeah. Well, what I used to tend to do as a young drinker was drink too much and go and take myself off so I could, you know, puke.
Yeah.
And then I'd have a little sleep. And, one time I woke up on the pavement outside.
What?
Bad, isn't it?
Did you woke up on the...
They carried me out because they were shutting. I'd gone to sleep properly for the night.
I never had that. I've only ever had a few blackouts. Mm. Yeah, proper. And again, that was when I was a teenager. It seems so obvious now where the way it was going to end up. But a few, I remember... that's not a very nice story, so I won't tell it. But I remember blacking out a few times.
I didn't black out, just nature's off switch. You were just... No more booze.
You were just gone. Well, that's fun times.
Yeah.
Fun boozy. I'm tempted to ask the 2 16-year-olds what's the booziest night they've ever had. But
I mean,
the
probes.
Yeah, we got it.
They can email us.
Well, listen, I feel... the point of this is, I am now a teen idol. And teenagers, the kids know who I am, mm-hmm. And so I'm thinking I should release a record. That seems like the obvious next step to really, really milk that teenage preteen market that is they've got so much money to spend.
What kind of tracks? What were you going to drop?
Grime, obviously. Those will do some grime.
You've already released the record.
Well, yeah, the record has.
Hello.
Hello,
I've had a few in the past.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, go on then.
beers in the past.
Yep. In the past 5 minutes.
Not
yeah.
Not too many. I've had a couple.
Okay.
Anyway, I don't drink no more. I don't.
Okay.
I'm just guzzled.
Okay. Part of me feels. Part of me finds Andre hilarious. Part of me really worries about
him. Yeah.
Really, I don't want to, you know, we're going to end in a minute. We're going to end on another buzzkill, but for all we know, a woman called Sue has been murdered because of my inaction, my inability to speak German. But I do worry about him because he's been calling me on and off for about 10 years. And I do. You know, he was a drunk then, and he's, what can I do? I can't do anything, guys. I'm just a human being who's going to go on television tomorrow morning on Good Morning Britain and break the last taboo on any
And what's a snail involved in that for?
Oh, I don't know. They want to put a snail on my face. Because it's like a health treatment that people are having when they have snails on faces. I'll be honest, I'm not keen. I don't like stuff like that. I don't like.
You tell them that I've got my self-respect.
No. I went, yeah, I'll be fine.
Which is your face and which is your ass afterwards?
No, I think it sounds like an insult. I think it's one of those clever things.
Hello?
Yes?
Yeah, I know what you can do. I know what you can do here when I next bump into you.
Yes?
I know. Oh, I've got a bloody nail on your show. I know what you can do.
This is going to break my heart, but yes.
Get the beers in. What else?
There we go. Now, I'm really trying to find an upbeat way of ending the show. Because we both, right, it's fine ending like the first half of the show on a weird dark vibe. Because you come back and we had so much fun when you weren't here, Catherine. I know you thought about fire, but actually it was more fun than any of this stuff.
Yeah.
And then to end the evening, to end the Sunday evening's entertainment on a vibe where we're all worrying about someone who may or may not be an alcoholic. And then these people are home,
yeah.
And they've got to kiss their children, mm-hmm. And they've got to get up in the morning and yeah. Go to work. So yeah. We need something.
Name snap?
No. Just stop trying to muscle in. Oh, I tell you what. Right, that's what I was thinking. You know rock, scissors, papers? Rock, paper, scissors. Right, you know that, yes. You know there's a Korean version of it? Where there's like an extra round in it. Does anyone else know this? Called Parmucci. Does anyone know this? It's because I was going to suggest playing it, but it's really, really difficult to explain how to play it.
Mm.
But
try.
All right, we got time. All right. So we do rock, paper, scissors. Right. So you go. So it's 1, 2, 3, go. Yeah.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, go. Right, okay, we've got scissors. Right, fuck it, do it again. 1, 2, 3, go. I'm fucking gonna keep those scissors. Fuck it. 1, 2, 3, go. Right, okay, it's rock. So you beat that. Right, so you've won round one.
Yes.
Then we go into round two, which is Parmucci.
Yeah.
And what you have to do is so par is rock.
Yes.
Moo is paper and chi is scissors, right? And what you have to do is you have to force me into doing chi at the same time as you. Right, you've got... No. All right. I'm fucked up. Why are you being a dick about this?
I went for the extra...
This isn't going to end on a dark vibe. It's now going on a weird vibe. Right, so let's just start again. So one, two, three, boom. Right, stop. I've got to get you, so hold that.
Yeah.
So I've got to get you to do chi at the same time as me.
Would you pa, have scissors?
Pa. You don't have to copy me if you don't want to. Chi. Pa. Pa. Moo. Moo. Pa. You got to fucking fuck's sake. Does anyone else get this?
No.
No.
We are not
No one leaves this room until you've all got it. Right? I have to force Catherine into doing chi.
Yeah.
Right.
With what? Jedi mind trick?
Yes, pretty much. So pa.
Yeah.
Pa.
Yeah.
Pa.
Mm-hmm.
Pa. You can't, you've got a chance though at some point.
Why?
Because you fucking have to.
It sounds like a trick.
Pa.
Yes.
Moo.
Yeah.
Moo.
Yeah.
Chi. Got ya!
Oi! Oi! Oh! Oh! Starting to get it. Starting to get it.
Right. So we do, now we go back, so it's one there. So now we go to rock, scissors, paper. Right. One, two, three, go. All right, you beat me. So now you've got to get me to do chi.
Pa. Chi.
There you go. She did it. She did it. She did it. Started, we're starting to get it. Another hour of this, and then I'm going to... Then I want you to pair up. One, two, three, go. Right, you won. Okay. Right, fine. Is that me?
Pa.
Yeah.
Moo.
Alright, oh, you've won that. Okay, so you get to go again, right?
What?
It's fine. This is another rule that wasn't in it. Go.
Pa.
Yeah?
Pa. Moo. Chi.
Oh, alright, so I'm in the lead now. So now I've... Because
I'm just saying noises.
Yeah, I know. So now I've got to go chi. Oh, fuck yes! Now we're getting it. Now we're getting it.
Is this for the end?
No, because we're getting it now. We will have fun. We will have fun. One, two, three, go. One, two, three, go. Right, you won. Go on then.
Pa. Moo.
Oh, great, you're in the lead. Go. Yeah, you're in the lead. It doesn't count. No. Go.
Chi.
So, so I'm in the lead now, so now I've got to go chi. Oh, fuck! Now... Any questions?
Yes!
Not from you.
Yes!
Not from you.
It's not
true. Right, any questions connected with this game, please, sir? Thank you.
What paper is it?
It's the highest quality watermarked paper that is for best letter writing. Has everyone got it?
No.
Right,
no.
Well then we keep playing it. It's worth...
Is this the part of Korea where they're not allowed to watch the telly apart from what Kim Jong-un says they can watch? Or is this fun Korea? Because...
Hello, Corey, you're down the rabbit hole.
Hello, yeah, I've just had my order. 16 Man Rose. Yeah, you haven't put shish kebab in.
Okay, yeah, we'll be there. We're just turning your corner now, sir.
Listen, no, you're messing me about. My fries are going to be cold.
No, we're on your street now, sir. Number 16, yeah?
Yeah, but no, you delivered it already. You didn't put the shish in there. You put the, listen, you put the bun kebab in, the chicken meat.
Oh.
But you didn't put the shish in.
Well, I can only apologise, sir. Do you know the game part of your chi, by any chance?
Listen.
Yep.
Put me some shish up and bring it down 16 miles by the road.
We'll be there in 20 minutes.
All right, don't forget some chips as well, boss.
Okay, boss. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Fucking hell. On that bombshell, you've been listening to The Rabbit Hole live from the Rondo Theatre in Bath. We have to cheat something very slightly. We've got to do the whole thing again. No, I'm joking. We've got to do two more intros, two more outros, then we're done, then we're going to unpack, and we'll go and then we'll quickly tidy all our stuff up, and then if you want to have pictures and all of that stuff, if you want your money back, that's Catherine's department. But if you want to have pictures and stuff, we'll do that next. So we're just going to record two more intros and two more outros. I shall do one. Ladies and gentlemen, live from the Rondo Theatre in Bath, it's The Rabbit Hole!
Ladies and gentlemen, and one 16-year-old, you're... bollocks.
Two 16-year-olds.
Two. Stereo. Three.
They're multiplying.
Well, and that's Broken Britain. Welcome to the Jeremy Kyle Show.
Ladies, gentlemen, and three, at the moment, 16-year-olds. Welcome to the Rabbit Hole, live from the Rondo Theatre. Back!
Do you want to do two outros?
You do one.
Okay. Well, that was awkward, wasn't it? That's the way I like it. Aha, aha. That was The Rabbit Hole live from the Rondo Theatre in Bath.
Go on.
I don't think that will do. That was the Rabbit Hole live from the Rondo Theatre here in Bath. Thank you for your patience. Please don't ask for your money back because I'm skinned. Bye!
What a very strange evening. You've been part of, thank you so much for your patience. You've been part of a very strange evening. This will be out in a couple of weeks. If you've not heard The Rabbit Hole, you can get it on iTunes, you get it on Acast. We tweet about it all the time, and we appreciate you coming, and we love this theatre. This is a beautiful place, and everyone's made us feel very welcome. So thank you. Give us 10 minutes to pack everything up, and then we'll kind of meet you out there, and we'll come and get pictures. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Right. Right. Let's get upstairs.